Hello and welcome to another episode of Patents TV. I'm your host, Jeff Bond, and this is episode 54. It's also our featured vendor presentation episode. And today we're going to have a vendor from AbleNet Incorporated, and Karen Ross Brown is going to share with us information on the Equals Mathematic Curriculum. Karen?
Hi everyone and welcome. This is Karen Ross Brown from AbleNet. I'm here to talk to you about Equals Mathematics Curriculum, a curriculum that was specifically designed for students with mild, moderate, and severe profound disabilities. If we are going to teach math to students with disabilities, it makes sense to provide instruction that is meaningful and complete, that allows us to raise expectations of our students and supports their unique needs. Of course, we want math lessons to be motivating, interesting, and engaging, and ultimately teach students how to think about math and solving problems. And of course, we need to include all learners as active learners of math. Equals was developed by drawing upon general education math standards from all regions across the country. We researched best practice math instruction from a wide variety of resources, mostly focusing on what has worked in general education. We also conducted action research so we could get feedback from students and teachers alike. We looked into the latest in brain research and learning strategies, as well as accessibility research. And of course, as this process has continued, we take feedback from special education instructors. We did at the time that Equals was developed, and we continue to do so. When we think about expectations for our students, as they increase, our opportunities for those students increase as well. We want to focus on teaching math skills in context, which is what a true curriculum does. What does math have to do with the context of these materials in my hand, in the context of the real world, and most importantly, in the context of the system of numbers, so students understand that math is interrelated. For example, knowing that the numbers on the clock are the same numbers that we count out loud. They are the same numbers that are on a ruler, on a scale, on page numbers, in a graph. In developing Equals, we decided to include all math content areas that were recommended by the National Council of Teachers of Mathematics so students could have comprehensive math instruction. Those math content areas are numbers and operations, algebra, geometry, measurement, data analysis, and probability. In addition, knowing that there are students who have very few or no skills in mathematics, we needed to have a starting place for them. So we added attending and exploring. So students who need that kind of instruction, for example, student will attend the math instruction, student will touch or tolerate touch of math manipulatives, that instruction would be present for them. Not every student needs to start there, but for those who do, it is present. From that point forward, students then connect their experiences, what they know about their lives, to math concepts, and then they build from that point forward. In looking at the five math content areas recommended by the National Council of Teachers of Mathematics, know that we're covering approximately kindergarten to fourth grade foundational skills of math. It is the area or the range of skills that most students in special education, whether they're in kindergarten or in 12th grade, struggle with the most. So when we say that Equals is appropriate for students in kindergarten through 12th grade, we're talking about those foundational skills that then relate to skills that move beyond the foundational skills, right? Thinking of vertical alignment to higher skills. We're talking about those. We wanted to provide age-neutral lessons then so all students could feel good about learning math using the materials and the lessons that were present. We also included the math process areas recommended by the National Council of Teachers of Mathematics, but we did so by embedding them in every lesson. Problem solving, representation, communication, reasoning and proof, and making connections. The main math methodology in Equals is concrete, semi-concrete, abstract. In every lesson, you will see the lesson objective is demonstrated to the students in a concrete way with hands-on manipulatives, in a semi-concrete way, such as with picture symbols representing those concrete items, and in an abstract way with numbers and symbols that you typically see in math. This is provided so all students truly understand what math is all about. And for those students who do have that understanding and are in that abstract place, they also benefit from using concrete and semi-concrete representations in order to help them with understanding and also by helping support their short-term memory as they solve problems. Differentiation is present in every single lesson at three levels, level 1, 2, and 3, so that teachers can find the appropriate support for students as they solve problems and as they learn. This is very flexible. It's the reason why all three levels are present in every lesson, so teachers can decide on the amount of support needed for students from even one lesson to the next. So in thinking about that access and how it relates to the lessons that are present beginning at Chapter 1 and ending at Chapter 12, you can be assured that that access for all three levels is present in every single lesson. The Equals Math curriculum has four main parts: Curricular Kit, Manipulative Kit, the Equals Technology Lesson Center, and a members-only website. Let's take a quick look at each of those. The Curricular Kit is all of the pre-printed materials that are organized into the box that you see on the screen. And these are the items that are in that Curricular Kit. Let's take a closer look. The Overview Manual is a teacher resource guide. It includes a scope and sequence as well as the list of skills from Chapter 1 through Chapter 12 in order. It also includes the Action Dictionary. The Action Dictionary is the second piece of differentiation. I mentioned the levels as one way to differentiate. The Action Dictionary is more of an individual focus. So if a student has needs an adaptation, let's say an action is required of that student in a lesson, and the student is unable to perform that action in a typical way, the Action Dictionary offers a variety of ways the teacher can adapt that action so that the student can indeed be an active learner and perform it. There are 12 teacher's guides with a definite sequence of lessons, and as I said, differentiation of levels 1, 2, and 3 embedded into each lesson. There are familiar environmental themes, mostly people environments and one animal environments in one chapter, to support students as they problem solve and are presented in an age-neutral way. So when students are solving problems, they're not solving a problem that is unrelated to what they're thinking about or what they're doing, but rather related to that theme that is introduced to them and they can become familiar with if they're not already familiar with it. Some examples are working in a pet store, hanging out at the mall, supermarket math, home, school, etc. And each lesson teaches a specific math objective that has been narrowed for success. The instructional resources that are present in the kit are work mats, so students can organize their thinking and organizing their manipulatives as they solve problems, as well as theme posters to help students understand the theme and find the math in the real world, as well as content posters. And finally, picture symbols supported vocabulary words and content cards for playing games and solving problems. The assessment is also included, mainly for placement, but also works well as a pre- and post-test. The Equals assessment has 6 subtests that match the 6 content areas I described earlier. And each test item is shown in a typical way and in an adapted way. The adapted version of the test item is to support students who need support in language, motor skills, and cognition so they can show what they know. We have added electronic scoring so teachers can now see the scores that the students received on the assessment in the order of lessons. Now they can see where the holes are and where the student's strengths are. The Manipulative Kit is quite expansive, a variety of tools for learning math, for understanding math, and also providing for adaptations as needed. We have a variety of concrete representations, as I said, and tools, and you can see how some of these are related to the themes. Here's turtles for in the pond, butterflies relate to rainforest, we also have food that relates to supermarket math, frisbees is a dog toy for working in a pet store. And then you also see a balance scale for learning about equal amounts, equal weights, a thermometer, fraction stacks, and many, many more. An example of one of the manipulatives that is used to support students and that you would find in the Action Dictionary as an adaptation is attaching objects onto the math line. The math line is in the kit, and think of it as a semi-concrete representation of a number line. We've added some concrete to that by attaching the manipulatives. So those students who have a hard time managing manipulatives, they just don't stay put and they get knocked off onto the floor, attaching those to the math line provides a way for students to use manipulatives to count, skip count, add, subtract, multiply, divide, or even find a constant increment in a pattern. Taking a look at a typical lesson, every lesson is organized in this manner. There are four pages to every lesson, starting with activating and building background knowledge to introducing and connecting that background knowledge to new concepts and vocabulary, teaching the lesson, and that's where you'll find concrete, semi-concrete, abstract, and students have a chance to solve problems, and then finally practice and application where you'll see real-life connections to the math, the lesson objective and the math concept, workstations, and two kinds of games. The Equals Technology Lesson Center is a web-based program that has been built to work on any interactive whiteboard, tablet, desktop, desktop with projector, or laptop. The Equals Technology Lesson Center contains all of the visual materials that are in the Equals kit. In addition to all of those materials, you will see a complete library of images. Here is an example of using that Equals Technology Lesson Center on a smart board. I have pulled up the poster for In the Garden, which is one of the themes, and I'm looking in the image file to locate a flower to plant in the garden, which I found, and I was able to pull it over and clone it with a little plus sign. And then I can use the tools from the smart board to circle it and write the numbers below. Just an example of one activity. Also note that most of the work mats and all of the game boards are switch accessible. Here you can see where I am placing with the switch the flower from this widget onto a 10 frame. I press it again and another appears. And finally, the last part of the kit is the members only website. The members only website is for teachers to access student materials, any updated materials, in-action videos of a variety of classrooms, virtual training, and a system for organization, lesson prep, and planning. To get to our website, our general website, you can find it at AbleNetInc.com, as you can see here. To get to the members-only website, you would need additional login information. If you are interested in seeing what's on the members-only website and getting your hands on a kit to really take a look at it, go to our website and look for the loan program where you can try it before you buy it, and you can get a loaner kit sent to you and request access so you can see everything that is on members-only. Here is an example of one of the pages of Members Only where you see multiple tabs and only a fraction of all the materials that are present on the Members Only website. Most of what is here has come from teachers, suggestions and comments about what they would like to see added to Equals. An example of that is the electronic scoring I mentioned, the Equals Technology Lesson Center, and also chapter tests have been added, plus much, much more. I also want to talk for a moment about our 3-year longitudinal independent research study that was completed at the Developmental Learning Program in Midlothian, Illinois. Across the 3 years, there has been a range of 43 to 72 students with mild, moderate, severe, profound disabilities, including autism, cognitive disabilities, and multiple disabilities. In using the equals assessment for pre- and post-test, looking at year one, the starting group of 72 students showed an average of 38% gains in math skills in that 1 year time. The next year, there were 58 students remaining. Looking at their performance in years one and two together, they showed 83% average gains over 2 years. And looking at year three, with 43% of the students remaining, and looking at their skills from year one plus year two plus year three, we see 112% average gains over 3 years. There was no regression reported for any of those students throughout the entire 3 years, and there are two additional groups who have also shown no regression and consistent significant progress. You can find the complete details on our website at AbleNetInc.com under research. You can download the January 2015 white paper and case study. We went to the Developmental Learning Program to see for ourselves, and what we saw were students who were visibly thinking, reconsidering their answers, changing their minds, and coming up with the correct solution. We saw students who were attending, engaged and interested, and truly proud and competent math learners, excited to show what they knew. Teachers told us that their expectations of their students had greatly increased and that they love teaching math now, whereas they did not before. They have become a community of learners. Teachers get together and talk about math, as one teacher put it, an insane amount of time. And students are becoming a community of learners, supporting each other and learning from each other as well. Inappropriate behaviors had greatly decreased, and students in the same math class were beginning to socialize outside of math class. Speech and language clinicians termed equals math language math because of the strong connection to math vocabulary and the emphasis on using it in the lessons repeatedly and with meaning. Also, students were observed using that math terminology outside of math class. Just to give you a little bit of an idea of how we support teachers, we take support for teachers very seriously. There are initial training options that are available. We have completely developed an organizational and lesson prep guide to help support teachers as they prepare their lessons. We provide access to pre-recorded webinars 24/7. We also provide follow-up webinars that are customized at no charge, no matter what training the teachers have used. And any members-only updates that have been made in the past, present, or future are available to all Equals users, no matter when they purchase the program. I also want to mention we have something new, Equals Pre-K, kindergarten readiness for students with disabilities or at-risk needs, or typically developing preschoolers, or all of those students who might be in the same classroom. As you can see, it's set up similarly with a pre-K content kit, manipulative kit, and members-only website. If you have questions about Equals, or Equals Pre-K, or any of our other curricular products, please contact Lisa Hall. She is our local representative. Her email address is lallhall@comcast.net, and her phone number is 317-570-9077. It's been a pleasure being with you here today. Thank you.
Thank you, Karen. Great information. I also understand that AbleNet will be at the ATIA conference in Orlando, Florida, the week of January 26th through the 30th. So you might have a chance to actually stop in and see the curriculum firsthand. That's going to wrap up today's episode of Patents TV. I hope to see you next time.